China have agreed to host a number of joint military events. The meeting between the two countries' defense ministers has led to both nations saying they'll take part in anti-terror exercises and share some of their military expertise. Well, for more, I'm now joined in the studio by Ruslan Vukov, who's the director of the Moscow-based Center for Analysis of Strategies and Technologies. Thank you indeed for joining us here. Now, not many countries get to work with China, so why Russia?
In fact, this is China who choose the partners for joint exercises. Because Chinese are very cautious. They are not disclosing. They are a rather closed nation as far as their military exercises policy. For instance, India, they exercise starting from Bangladesh up to the United States, including Russia, like with a wide number of nations, those who are inferior, those who are more advanced. But Chinese are very closed. And until 2005, we also had no exercises. We had a mutual arms trade, but no military cooperation. That's why, in fact, this is Chinese who choose their partners, and we are among those with whom they exercise.
So how do the two countries hope to benefit from this?
In fact, the essential thing which people achieve at the end of this exercise and during them and preparing them, this is trust. Because the lack of trust leads to conflicts and misunderstanding and misperceptions. This is probably the main goal. But apart from this jointness, it's also important, and we know more about each other. And we should always keep in mind that, at least theoretically, Russia and China, this is the only ones who can take the challenge of the United States in military field, because all the other countries or coalition of the countries are unable to do it technically.
So what kind of reaction is this likely to get in the West?
I don't think that West would be nervous, because both Russia and China, we are just at the beginning of the way. Plus, despite these exercises, we have very controversial relations. Yeah, we have long-lasting border. We have very complex and complicated history, both in military way and in some other ways. That's why it doesn't mean that Russia trains with China against West or against the United States. Yeah, we can't say that this is the beginning of military alliance. Plus, China has much more important and tangible interest on the Asia Pacific. We have a little bit less. That's why the projection of the force of China is exactly against the US. Our one is not. That's why I don't think that the West would be extremely nervous, and especially the United States.
Okay, well, we have to leave it there for now. Thank you very much, Ruslan Vukov. Thank you for that.